hurt myself again today.
The story came in 1988, you know, at the age of 12, in the evening when the rebels came and attacked the whole village. And they raided 15 boys from here. And we were all given guns. We had to go because the only way, if you don't go, you have to be killed. If you go, you survive. So we all accepted to go by force. And we walked 100 miles in 3 days to another district. When the rebels took us, they forced you to kill and to go in the villages looking for food, you know. You have to loot for food and beating people up. When the government plane came to attack the rebels, you know, that's when everybody had to run away, and that's the only time we had a chance to escape. The plane started shooting bombs, mistaking us to be the rebels. And if you don't crawl like a monkey, the bullets get you. And we ended up losing all our friends, 9 of them. Then 6 of us survived, reaching home up to now. That's when I went back to school and started running.
Hold me, wrap me up.
Friday, then on Saturday, I represented my county, Otuke, to be selected on a district team later. Then I won 3 races with no shoes, you know, after run a night before 50 kilometers. Then I was chosen to represent later to go to Kampala, capital city, at the age of 15.
Giving them a stone, you know, the reason for the hope that burns your soul. Just sleeping peacefully wasn't meant to be undisclosed. Oh, don't you know? When you live in a city on a hill, you got to shine your light. When you live in a city on a hill, you got to shine your light.
Got hold 11 kids, yeah. Year 2003, when I was running, laying under the bus. Then I talked to them, asking where their parents, they said they're being shot. Then I asked them, like, they started asking me with the money. Then I said, I don't have money, I'm from running. Then I walked them home, you know. I think this is like almost 3-2 kilometers. You know, I talked to my dad if he would take care of them. And he accepted. Then I started supporting them.